Welcome everyone here at Stordyr Gaming for a new episode of XCOM 2. I went over the books and I will see the magnetic weapons coming in 2 days, how much it is. I only got 250 supplies, so I won't be able to upgrade all of my soldiers. And also I have to choose whether or not I want to get the workshop already. I have to clean out 3 alien machinery or an exposed power coil, and doing this with gremlins is gonna be of big help, right? So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to build the workshop within 10 days, and then I will get more supplies from this as well, and then I can upgrade more weapons. So that's the order of things. But there will certainly come a mission in between, so for now, I could go for the signal. I won't. That's the Shen mission. And there is a black market, which I need to search for.
Avenger plotting.
That's what I'm going to do. There's not a whole lot of loot I can sell just yet, but if I can, or if I have enough loot, I don't want to scan for more.
This research can only further our advances.
These magnetic-based weapons are a lot like the early railgun prototypes. They fire projectiles at extremely high velocity.
Yeah. Yeah, she's very satisfied with herself about this. Alright, magnetic rifle, shotgun, mag pistol, starter mag, and gauss weapons. I could do the sectoid autopsy instantly, yes.
Though I was never witness to one myself, countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
Yeah, it's ugly. It's really ugly.
The sectoid's rapid physical evolution
psionics
of the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic
new
engineering
research
and their pursuit of advancement, regardless of the risks.
Should I go for gauss weapons already? Do some more autopsy? Oh, I could do the faceless autopsy? Let's do that.
From my own experience,
also,
Advent generally deploys
I got promotions to do
rather than subterfuge when it comes to protecting their primary facilities. At least the ones I had access
so
to.
So, Dennis,
if they have gone to the trouble of hiding this black site,
medical,
I suspect our findings there will lead us to even
or
greater
combat
questions.
Protocols. I'm thinking combat protocols. Yep. And you, sir, that, you know, this is close combat specialist is really good. It is really good. Move in, and then, you know, against nearby enemies. But close and personal, if you want to do, like, run and gun, like run and gun, then close and personal. 30% crit. It's just so good. And then rapid fire. Yeah. He's the aggressive type. Right, and he's been in my last Let's Play as well, so that's happening. Good. Got this part. I think I was scanning for the black market. Yeah. Faceless autopsy one day.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries.
Let's see if we can already do a mimic beacon.
How the aliens could conceive of such a being. Is there another world out there filled with these shape-shifting creatures?
That.
Or are they merely another construct of alien genetic tampering?
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you.
I need
you as
another
soon
faceless
as the
corpse.
New orders, Commander?
Okay.
You'd be surprised how big of a difference some of these things can make in combat, Commander. With a few supplies, I can manufacture anything we need in no time.
Oh, I don't have any alloys, so I can't upgrade anyway. Well, that is easy. Let me make one of these.
What do you know about these gene therapy clinics, Doctor? They seem like a big draw for the cities right now.
Having worked in one of the facilities, I can tell you firsthand.
They do offer a level of medical care unmatched by any previous effort in our history.
The aliens have effectively cured all of humanity's greatest ailments. Cancer, malaria, AIDS. The process is relatively simple.
I'm beginning to see the appeal.
Yeah, I'm selling a couple of corpses. Because, you know, I don't really need them. We'll keep one or two. What do I need those guys for? 6 for the Predator armor upgrade. Okay. I won't need the drones. See, that's 52 supplies, which is not bad. Now let's see what we can buy. I think I have to buy everything with intel. Yeah. Laser sight, expanded mag. Engineer. But 95, that's all of my intel. Yeah, I can't do that. Well, maybe I come back for you later. I know I am low on engineers, but what can I do? I could actually... Huh.
Setting course for the East African sector.
No, wait. I could make Africa complete. That's 30 intel only. Yeah, let's do this.
Commander, we utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
And we will, Shen. We will.
Attempting to establish local regional contacts.
Commander, we just got...
Oh, there's the supply rate I've been waiting
line.
For.
We have an opportunity to salvage some...
All right, Advent Train.
Assuming we can clear out the alien forces guarding the site first.
Advent Train.
Setting
I hate
for
Advent
Sector
Trains.
13, South Africa.
Anyway, let's do this mission. Let's see whom we get. Yeah, so... These two guys. No, it's basically the same team as before. Do I really need her for this mission? No. I will rather take I will rather take Rachel. Get her a promotion. Is that true? Yeah. Okay, here, make weapons available. Come on! And get her the... The boatcaster for this mission. Yep. Frost bomb. Axe. Boatcaster. Let's do this. Let's kick some alien asses. To S's.
Sky Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe. 5x5.
Yeah. Rachel's gonna be a sharpshooter. And so will John. But John, I think, wanted to be a gunslinger. So I never used a gunslinger with a perk pack. It's going to be very interesting as well.
They've left plenty of cargo for salvage. That's where we come in. Once you're on the ground, eliminate all hostile contacts and secure the area. Seize anything of value.
Sure. We will do that. And we will try not to blow up too much stuff. Although I like blowing up stuff. But I need the alloys. So, let's see. And they don't know we're here, I think.
Menace 1-5. Coordinates of the Advent Train are locked in. Move to secure. Eliminate all hostiles.
That's the train. I foresee all kinds of line of sight issues.
Stay clear of those turrets.
Oh, turret.
We're still not entirely sure if they're fully automated or remotely triggered.
Yeah, I think it's worth blowing our cover immediately. I still will keep two concealed people. Just saying. But they can now move more freely. See? For example, they could move right here. Let's hope they don't. That's not too. And another turret. Holy shit! Oh, what a. Oh, look at this. Whoa! I'm not sure why they didn't. Oh, I think because I have this this mod that if you go around an edge, it doesn't spot you if you enter a surveilled zone. Okay, so I got another turret. Alright, can you see them? No. Okay, so that means here they would see me, here they wouldn't. Alright. So let's move up to here then. It's not as far as I would have loved to go, but then again, I don't want to be uncovered immediately. So you go over here. And again, here you see me, here you don't. Let's go here.
Moving to designated position.
Marshall will stay here and overwatch.
Moving to overwatch.
Let's see how they move. Yeah, they move away. Which is good. Which is really good. So I should not activate them if
Understood.
I move
Moving
Marshall
out.
Over here. I do. So they can look further than they can shoot. Okay. And we spotted him, and I activate the turret. That was unfortunate. That was a wrong assumption on my side, but that's fine. Let me see if there's any supplies in there that I need. They're back here. So, nope. 68%, huh? Yeah, that stinks. Ugh. Haywire. Another combat protocol. Actually, I could. Yeah, let's take out that second turret without explosives. Gives me some more opportunities here. There goes my combat protocols, but I think they're both well used. So I could now run here with Maurizio. No, run here with Maurizio. Have cover from there. Throw the axe at the officer. Hopefully drop him. 50% to kill him. Critical. And to quote a familiar movie, I get another attack. Okay. That's fine. I will take the drone down with someone else. Like, yeah, I think I want Marshall to get this kill. if he can actually make it. Yep, he can. He needs some promotion as well.
Target neutralized.
Good. And
moving
there goes
to
the
designated
music.
Coordinates.
Everything is calm again.
I'm on it.
And I can use Overwatch a little more. What is going on here?
They gave me some Ziel.
I'm very zoomed out.
Bin dabei.
Ah, okay.
Rolling.
So Darren, you come in.
Scanning.
Moving to designated position.
So that's two turrets and one pod, right?
On Overwatch.
I don't want to run too far with you.
Ordenes confirmadas.
If you go here.
That's the equipment we're
after.
That's
the equipment we're after.
We have to do our best to avoid destroying the gear while we secure the area.
Okay. I could explode it. But that also means that there's no one close right now.
Affirmative.
So let's move up with Darren. And
no need
let's
to
move
ask
up
twice.
With Rachel, who already got her promotion. That's very cool. And Mark needs to be closer to the action. Once there is actual action.
Move.
A Viper! Hello, Viper! Was that a hit? No, it was not. Yeah, grazed. Or just minimal damage. What's the second?
Without the introduction of human DNA,
surveillance
these
drone.
Creatures
okay.
Once operating under the guise of thin men, now show their true form. A
trooper.
Reptilian species.
No reason for them to hide.
And a drone.
The aliens
okay.
Don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
Moving to designated coordinates.
60% for the trooper, but 8 protocol I think is more important right now. Question is, oh, that would be full cover for you. Yeah, take on the Viper with the axe. Yeah, and kill it. Very nice.
Baja confirmada. Por aquí hay tropas de Advent.
Oh, that was not so nice. Damn it. A gunner. Ugh. And a stun lancer. Holy shit. Alright, I need to take down this guy. Can I do this? Well, I can do it. Just like this. Or I run and gun here to full cover. Yeah, I think that's
it.
I run and gun here. Full cover. And take him down. Yeah. Shotgun to the face, I told you. I told you. And he's now in full cover, so he will probably 8 protocol Maurizio, since he's quite exposed from that direction. Quite exposed is good. I have still the drone to worry about. And a sectoid. And a stun lancer. Holy shit. It's all too far away, basically.
Moving on target location. Overwatch!
He can only overwatch from here.
Leaving
Rachel might actually
position.
Be able to kill one. With a lucky shot. Stun Lancer? Yeah, let's try that. Yes!
Okay. Hostile neutralized.
That's only 2 shots at Maurizio. He could survive this. That was really an unfortunate activation there. Right? So let's see. If I'm lucky, I can freeze one of them. I cannot freeze one of them. I could blow up the entire thing, but that is not even a guaranteed kill. So let's see. There comes the drone and takes my Overwatch shot. Well, at least the drone is down now.
Enemy eliminated.
I'm so worried about this. And you missed the Overwatch shot.
Missed.
Is he shooting? Yeah. Oh, he misses. Awesome. Now let's just hope that the same goes for the gunner. Yes! That's half cover for him. Okay. Whew! I got lucky there, I admit it. That activation? Not perfect. Okay. Let's do this. 69? Yeah, sure. Try your luck. Huh? Nope.
Oh, come on!
That's what I say usually. Alright, so Maurizio, with your axe, you go after the gunner. He's the more dangerous enemy, actually. If these guys hit, they do a whole lot of damage, as evidenced by Marshall. I'm not so sure about this stage of the game, but in general, they are very dangerous. Okay, so 58. Oh no! No, no, that's not what I wanted to do! Damn it! I didn't want to blow up the crate. Come on, game. Yeah. If I'm lucky, that was it. 9 damage against the sectoid. Area secure?
Status confirmed. Yeah. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
At least no one got, you know, harmed. 10 aliens. Flawless. Good. 66% successful shot. Maurizio dealt most damage. Yeah, with the axe. That's like really good. That will change at some point to Warbanker. Because if he gets the shard gun, or even later the, what is that, storm gun, it's just so ridiculously, with rapid fire, so much damage. Plus I have Neo Viking, and if he's with chain shot and proper ammunition, that will also do a lot of damage.
The aliens are probably still wondering what hit him.
Couple of promotions, I get a hair trigger, data pads, laser sight, turret racks, drone racks, corpses, 64 alloys, that's good, 15 crystals, 3 Illyrium cores, and 114 supplies, that is a good number. Yep, yep, yep. I will need a lot of this stuff. A lot of this stuff. So let's do those promotions real quick. Rachel is gonna be a sharpshooter. Where is that? Here. Good. That means that she will also get the
Shadowkeeper.
The way
this one is sighted in, there's no excuse for missed shots.
Can we upgrade? That's laser sight, that's plus 5 critical. I'd rather put that on a... for now. Okay, let's see. Warbanker, you get... Slugshot's not bad. Fire shot with no range penalties, use 2 ammo. but this is plus 10 crit. Right. And the trench gun is just amazing. I will take trench gun because it's an area of effect. And that's just so much better. Yeah. Alright, then I can upgrade this weapon, and that means the laser sight goes right here. Plus 5 critical. Yep, that's that will hurt. Let's put it this way. Okay, you're a support gunner. That means you get demolition. I got 2 sergeants. Let's head to the Guerrilla Tactics School as well. Combat protocol. Covering fire is not bad, but I will use smoker. And Maurizio is going to get 25 bonus and 25 critical when attacking enemies when concealed. Lone Wolf plus 10 aim, plus 10 defense. But 7 points or 7 distance is quite a lot. Hunter's Instinct is against flanked enemies, and axe attacks have a 15% chance to critically hit enemies. And that's always. So it's gonna be Hunter's Instincts for him. And that's the promotions. Very nice. Now, Guerrilla Tactics School. Let's see, John wanted to be a sharpshooter too, but he's going to be more the gunslinger type. I can get another squad upgrade, or the first one. I can get Vulture, because I'm very greedy. And I think I will pass on this one, and rather for now.
Hey, Commander.
And now that I have the alloys, I'd rather get stutter mag or magnetic rifles. Magnetic rifles, it is.
Having never stepped foot in one of the city centers, I've never actually had one of these.
Low engineers for resistance comes at capacity. I know that.
No one really seems to be asking the hard questions either. Like,
Commander, we've located the site where Big Sky took off from. No immediate signs of activity. Hold on. Might have something. It's a weak signal on an open channel.
Out this area. Region are of particular concern.
Whatever you say, Valen. Whatever you say.
Is that Valen?
Yep.
Haven't had any signs of her since we lost HQ. Commander, if there's any chance she or Big Sky are still alive, we have to get down there.
Yeah, but not yet. Those alien rulers are no joke. I want to kill them in this playthrough, but they're no joke. So I will wait at least until I get laser weapons. I think I will wait until I get laser weapons, and then I will start this process. Right? Okay. I think that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe to the channel, and please leave a comment about how much you liked it, or how much you hated it as well, right? If you have some ideas on how I can make this content better, then let me know in the comments as well, and I hope I see you for the next episode here at Stordyr Gaming. Until then, I'm Stordyr.